tijd.
Enough.
Ga je wat op?
Pres en dus. So this is a Land Rover gearbox. You can separate it in two parts, like the gearbox and the transfer case. So Land Rovers are made in England, and English stuff tends to leak quite a lot. Land Rover is no exception in this case. Especially the gearbox, they have a lot of joints where things come together and where shafts start spinning and they start to leak there. So my main goal for today is to remove this cover, take off those nuts. Then have a look inside, clean it a little bit, and then paint this cover, maybe black or so. Install a new gasket with some liquid gasket as well, and then put it back, top up some oil, and hopefully then it will be dry. So I raised the car by a bit, just by using those ramps. And now you can see on the bottom here, this is the cover plate, and there is some oil leaking. There are some drips already now, so let's take it off and have a look inside. So now that the oil is out, it's time to remove this cover. So now that all the nuts have been removed, it's time to take off the cover. Hopefully it will come up easy. So as you could see, there is some smoke covering the whole gearbox. So the nice thing about those old gearboxes and engines is that everything is made out of metal. This is cast aluminium, and those are metal plates. The disadvantage of metal is that it starts to rust, and as you can see also this plate, it's heavily rusted. so now that the transfer box is finished, I also like to address this leak. A common place for those Land Rovers to leak is around the shaft seal. Well, to my surprise, it's just the outer gasket which is leaking between those flanges, because normally the seal behind this drive shaft will start to leak and then all the oil gets around the brake shoes, but that's not the case, so that saves some work. So now it's time to dismantle. So the actual part you see here is the piece which connects the wheel to the drive shaft. So as you can see now, the wheel is just spinning freely and doesn't connect anymore to the drive shaft. So this flange is splined, as you can see here. Those splines connect to the splines from the drive shaft, and this splined flange is connected to the wheel hub, and so the wheel does turn as well together with the drive shaft. Inside you see the wheel bearings down there. So I jack the car up on an angle so that the oil will stay mostly on that side of the axle. Between here there should be a paper gasket. Looks like there is not much left of the gasket. So I will now clean up those surfaces and then install a new gasket together with some liquid gasket, and then put it back together. So just having a look on the other side, this side engages to the differential and it looks all fine. So during off-road it's possible to snap one of those shafts, but as you can see now it's just an easy and quick way to replace it for a new one. It just slides in. And once it's far enough, you just line it up with the differential, and that's it. It just engages with the differential. So you can see now what's happening. If the bolts are not connected, the inner shaft is disconnected from the wheel, and if you insert a bolt, then the wheel will spin as well. So to install this cap you need to hammer on it, and there is not a good place to hit this thing since it's made out of thin sheet metal. So once I was on board, I fabricated this thing. It's a cap which slides over this cap, and now you can just hit on this thicker piece of steel, and then it will just slide on evenly. So I never used it, as you could see, it's still brand new. And it's welded inside. So let's give it a try. So now it's a matter of installing back the tire and fill up the transfer case. Maybe check the oil level from the axle as well, since they lost a little bit of oil. Then I consider this job as done. I also will change the hubcap from the other wheel. So from the other side, it still has the red hubcap. But the nice thing about this side is that it's completely dry. So the next job will also be on this Land Rover. It has to do with the drivetrain. It's currently okay. But it just looks crappy. It's starting to rust and the joints are slowly getting worn. So if you're a Land Rover owner, you of course will directly recognize them. They're the U-joints from the drive shafts. So they're brand new, 4 pieces of them, together with the 2 new gaiters, which I will install on the front and aft drive shaft. So yeah, stay tuned for the next video and see you in the next one.